Customs is an ancient organization which was seen in Egypt 4,500 years ago. That time, the whole country was ruled by only army and customs. Customs is an international department which is going on almost same process all over the world.
In Bangladesh, custom is responsible for collecting revenue and for controlling the flow of goods including animal, transports, personal and hazardous items in and out of the country.
As a result, the economy is in a shattered state.
Bangladesh Customs was formed under the National Board of Revenue in 1972 under the President's Order No. 72. At present, Bangladesh Customs is mainly working on revenue collection, clearance of imported and exportable goods, anti-smuggling activities and border protection.
The world economy is growing faster. Considering international trade, the WTO is playing a vital role for boosting trade facilitation all over the world. As a member of WTO and signatory of WTO-TFA, it became obligatory for Bangladesh to implement TFA provisions.
Part of that, the National Board of Revenue has undertaken a great initiative to modernize customs. The initiatives have been taken by the National Board of Revenue are being supported by development partners like World Bank, the USA BTFA, the ADB, COICA, KCS, JICA and IMF. I also thank the government for their absolute support in modernizing the customs. I thank our Honorable Finance Minister, Honorable Finance State Minister and our Honorable Chairman for their moral support and other support which we require to introduce this system. Within 2022, the whole world will see that Bangladesh Customs has modernized in a way that it is in the same pace with the customs of developed countries.
The National Board of Revenue has taken a lot of initiatives to modernize Bangladesh Customs. Earlier, Bangladesh Customs has initiated a strategic action plan 2014 to 2017 for proper and timely implementation of the said provisions. Besides, the NBR has taken some initiatives for the modernization of Customs Department.
Authorized Economic Operator, Risk Management, National Single Window, Advance Ruling, Publishing Information by Website, National Inquiry Point,
Post-Clearance Audit, Release Time of Good, Pre-Arrival Processing, Advance Passenger Information or Passenger Name Record, Expedited Shipment,
Scanning System, etc.
The NBR has a remarkable achievement in TFA implementation. However, we have to complete the remaining issues as well. Bangladesh Customs has taken a lot of initiatives to implement authorized economic operator.
Basically, AEO ensures simplified declaration, convenient clearance, fewer controls,
priority treatment, recognition, reward for complaint traders.
Recently, Bangladesh Customs amended the Customs Act to introduce AEO. An SRO has been issued on AEO detailing the methods to implement AEO.
The NBR organized a lot of training events for customs officers and relevant stakeholders with the support of development partners, and we are on the way to introducing pilot program for AEO with three pharmaceutical companies.
Risk management is also a provision of the WTO-TFA that we have to implement. The RM system will help Bangladesh Customs to identify the risky consignment.
Therefore, the compliant and honest importers or exporters will be able to release their consignment without physical or documentary examinations. There are four channels for clearing goods.
They are green, yellow, blue and red.
To facilitate the trade, NBR has amended the Customs Act 1969 to introduce the risk-based custom controls. The NBR has already formed central and local risk management unit.
The NBR is working to establish a full-fledged RM directorate. Considering modernization activities, the NBR is going to develop a risk management software very soon.
The National Single Window is a single platform for the traders to get one-stop service from the government agencies to clear imported and exportable goods in a faster and scientific manner. With implementation of National Single Window for trade in Bangladesh, 319,000 traders are expected to be benefited with the average processing time.
For importation, time will be reduced to 122 hours. For exportation, time will be reduced to 88 hours. The government of Bangladesh has already approved National Single Window Project, nominating Bangladesh Customs as the lead agency to monitor and operate NSW.
Furthermore, the NBR has already formed Project Implementation Unit, assigned officers, developed the short and long-term work plan, and initiated procurement.
As a further step, the NBR has signed Memorandum of Understanding with the 39 ministers and government agencies who will be the main actors of National Single Window initiatives.
As a member of WTO and signatory of WTO TFA, it is an obligation for Bangladesh to implement WTO TFA provisions. Customs modernization is imperative to prevent revenue leakage and offer the hassle-free services to traders. National Board of Revenue is always working to create a trade-friendly environment and support the trading community to boost up domestic and international business. I am happy to let you know that the modernization plan embodies a balancing situation to ensure revenue protection and trade facilitation.
The NBR has already implemented advance ruling. This process will highly be beneficial for traders and customs.
For traders, add certainty and predictability to international trade, helps traders to make proper business decision. For customs, acquire advanced knowledge on classification, origin, etc. Advance information on import and for risk management.
The NBR has formed an advanced ruling unit and issued an SRO detailing the procedure of advanced ruling. And the NBR has already issued 11 advance ruling on classification. The NBR has conducted several awareness seminars on advance ruling in Dhaka and Chittagong, and has also planned to conduct such type of seminars all over the country.
The WTO Trade Facilitation Agreement emphasized on publication of trade-related information. That is why Bangladesh Customs introduced a comprehensive website on customs matters. The address of the website is www.bangladeshcustoms.gov.bd. The website contains almost all customs-related information, including legislation, important SROs, and orders.
The NBR developed an AP mechanism where relevant day-to-day questions are archived as FAQ. Anyone can send a query to NAP visiting Bangladesh Customs website. If the answers are not available in the FAQ, the inquirer may send questions to NAP. The NAP team of NBR will give answer of the query. A detailed standing order for the management of NAP has already been issued.
There are two types of post-clearance audit. system-based PCA and transaction-based PCA. The NBR is working on implementing both type of PCA. Presently, the customs officer are practicing transaction-based post-clearance auditing. Hopefully, the NBR will be able to initiate system-based post-clearance auditing in all customs offices. To achieve this goal, the NBR has already trained about 150 customs officers on system-based and transaction-based PCA, including 20 expert trainers on post-clearance auditing.
Additionally, an office order and a PCA manual on transaction-based PCA have already been published to contact PCA properly.
Training of the trainers, manual for system-based PCA has been prepared and distributed accordingly. A local PCA unit has been formed in all customs house and station.
The NBR has a plan to conduct more workshop, seminars and training events on PCA so as to educate the officers and stakeholders regarding PCA. The NBR conducted 4 time release studies from 2014 to 2016 in Chattogram, Benapol, Dhaka, ICD Customs House. A national workshop on TRS was conducted in Chattogram in October 2017.
The NBR would expect all the customs house and LC station to contact TRS regularly based on the data available in SI Coda world to get regular update on customs clearance time. Because of NBR's initiative based on the finding of TRS, clearing time for imported goods is reduced from 11 days to 8 days, and for exported goods is reduced from 8 days to 5 days.
This is now an international practice to start processing of clearing goods before arrival. Bangladesh Customs is also going to start this process officially. NBR has taken initiative of necessary amendment on Customs Act 1969 to introduce PAP. NBR has arranged some seminars, awareness programs and workshop with all the stakeholders regarding PAP, and it will be continued.
To reduce hassle of passengers in the international airport and to prevent anti-smuggling activities, this is highly required to implement advanced passenger information or passenger name record system in Bangladesh.
The NBR has taken some initiatives along with Civil Aviation Authority Bangladesh to implement API or PNR in Bangladesh. The NBR made necessary amendments in the Customs Act to introduce API or PNR.
Following the guidelines of WTO Trade Facilitation Agreement, the NBR took initiatives to implement expedited shipment. Managing the postal and courier imports is the real challenge across the world at present.
The NBR has already made necessary amendments to initiate effective de minimis in order to expedite postal and courier shipments. However, the NBR is working on automation, risk management and infrastructural rearrangement for ensuring expedited shipments.
A project under public-private partnership on scanning system has been approved by the government of Bangladesh. This project will cover scanning system at all the customs houses and stations within the country, and it will give a new shape on customs activities. There will be a central and local scanning division to monitor the activities of this system.
Bangladesh Customs is undertaking many technological and management processes. Also, member of the WTO World Trade Organization, Bangladesh Customs has obligations to fulfill certain requirements, like it has already signed a CQDA project with WTO and World Customs Organization. Bangladesh Customs has set up other modernizations also, like doing business like authorized economic operators, national single window. In that light, various work that it is undertaking in this area will improve its capacity, will strengthen its service delivery system. Thereby, it will increase our GDP, will increase the per capita income, and also improve our living standards. our work in this area will continue in the coming days, and we will undertake more modernizing processes in order to raise the level of service given by Bangladesh Customs to much higher level.
The proposal of new Customs Act has already been approved and it is going to be implemented very soon. Customs Modernization Test has taken the second strategic action plan 2018-2022 for Bangladesh Customs. There are 10 program areas in this strategic action plan. These are strategic planning, financing and management of modernization initiatives,
human resource management, governance and integrity,
policy, legislation and procedures,
infrastructure development with built-in modern business process,
customs e-environment,
trade facilitation and passenger facilitation,
tariff rationalization and standard variation,
modernization of bonded warehouse and other export incentive facilities,
regional integration and partnerships,
communications and public relations.
The volume of international trade is increasing day by day.
Therefore, we need to modernize and automate the manual system so as to face the ongoing challenges of international trade.
As an emerging tiger of South Asia, Bangladesh is going to be a middle-income country soon.
Thus, we have taken initiatives to implement the Trade Facilitation Agreement of WTO, which will enhance the economy of the country by facilitating international trade.